This video is brought to you by NordVPN. Hey guys, it's Jordy here for CineCam.net, and you're watching Copycat Friday, a weekly series in which we recreate certain effects from popular music videos and films. But you know what, guys? Time just goes so fast lately. It feels like I can't breathe anymore. And that's why we are recreating this effect right here, which comes from Ariana Grande's Breathing. Ariana Grande recently came out with her new music video, Breathing, in which you can see her move at normal speed, but everyone else around her goes super fast. And this is not really something new. Many artists have used this effect before. Even the Backstreet Boys also did it in their latest clip, Chances. Now, the cool thing about this effect is that there are two ways to pull it off. There's an advanced technique and a super basic one, and both can be done inside Adobe Premiere Pro. What you want to do is film in a crowded place, but I'm a little bit afraid that people will walk in front of the camera, push the camera over, or just act stupid. So that's why we brought a bunch of clothes that we are just going to wear ourselves and just walk multiple times in front of the shot. That's the idea. So now we're packing everything in and go to a beautiful nature place where we can film all of our shots. Let's do that. Now let's start off with the basic technique. This one is how the Backstreet Boys did it. You wanna lean or stand in front of an object, and this could be a tree or a big rock like we did it. Now important is that you fit completely within that object. You then film yourself from a tripod. You can say or do something, and we're gonna use this as the normal speed part. Next up, keep the camera rolling on the tripod and let some people run around. And like I said before, you can do this in a crowded area or just walk through the shot yourself multiple times. Now pay attention though that you never walk in front of the subject that will be at normal speed. Since we're gonna speed this part up in Premiere Pro, you might also wanna decrease the shutter speed of the camera. And I'm actually setting mine to a fifth of a second, and this will introduce more motion blur as you move around. Now, not all cameras can do this though, but it's not a necessary thing. If you are familiar with photography time lapses, you could also do that at a lower shutter speed. And that's the only thing that we're gonna need. We can now fire up Adobe Premiere Pro. Start off by placing your fast forwarded shot into the timeline, using the Rate Stretch tool, which you can find in the toolbox, or by pressing the R key on your keyboards, we can click and drag the clip smaller. What we're doing now is just speeding up the clip. Next up, place the other shot on top of that clip in your timeline. With it selected, head over to the Effects Controls, Opacity Property, and here click on the Pen tool. With that tool, we can draw a mask around the rock, and you can do this pretty rough. And you know, that's basically it. Super easy. And now comes the advanced technique, which will open up more possibilities, which is how they've done it in the clip from Ariana Grande. Essentially, your fast forwarded clip goes exactly the same. You run around like crazy people in front of the camera, or you find yourself a crowded place. Like before, you can shoot this at a slower shutter speed. Again, pay attention that nobody walks between the subject and the camera. Always stay in the background. Next up is your normal shot, but you want to hold a green screen in the background now. And we are using a portable screen, which is pretty cheap, and you'll have a ton of fun with that. So it's definitely something that I would recommend getting if you don't have one yet. So those are the two shots to get the basic effect working, but what about the people that walk in front of you? I mean, you can't actually walk in front of your subject, but then how did they do it in the actual music video? Well, if you look closely, the front people were added in separately in post-production. So we're gonna have to make a third shot, but this time in our own studio. If you want people to come in front of you, it actually means that you need to key them out or mask them out in some sort of a way. You could essentially do that in front of a green screen, but because of that motion blur we're getting through the slow shutter speed, it's gonna be really hard to do that. So that's why we're going to set something up here in our studio. What you wanna do is film in front of a black background. Now you can also take a black fabric like here, just hang that up in the background. And then you want to light your subject, and we're using this softbox right here with a grid inside. And that grid is going to help us to guide the light to point it only towards our subject. If you do still have spill light on the background, which you want to keep dark, then you can use something like this right here, which is a flag, which Jannik is setting up right here through a C-stand. And that way you can flag off the spill light. And finally, if you don't have all of that gear, then I can really recommend to get yourself some black wrap. This is basically aluminum foil painted black. It's really cheap, and it actually helps you to wrap around any light. You can bend it in any way. It's also heat resistant, and that way you can kind of get rid of that spill lighting. So like before, also here, set your camera to a very slow shutter speed and just let someone walk in front of your frame like Jannik is doing right now. He's wearing this funny jacket, but he's going to change that now into a different outfit, walk through the frame again, etc. Take a couple of these shots and that's the only thing that you're gonna need. And now we can dive back into Premiere Pro.
Like before, place your fast forwarded clip in the timeline and use the rate stretch tool to speed it up. Next, put the green screen shot on top, go to opacity and take the pen tool. Now draw inside of that green screen. Next up, search for the ultra key effect. Apply it to the clip and use the color picker to remove the green. If you're having trouble with pulling off a good green key, then definitely make sure to check out our in-depth tutorial on how to use the ultra key, which you can find the link to in the description below. And then finally are the people that move in front of your subject. Place that on the top of your edit. With it selected, go to the opacity property and change the blending mode to screen. You're telling to Premiere now to only show the brighter areas, which is why the black background is gone. Like before, use the rate stretch tool to speed that clip up as well. And if you're still seeing something from your background through the blending, then open up Lumetri and decrease the exposure. Now guys, I want to talk a little bit about NordVPN, who contacted me a while back. But before I commit to any sponsor, I always test their service or product first. So I've been using NordVPN for about a month now. Essentially what NordVPN does is connect you to any of their servers across the world. You're making a secure connection, hiding your online identity. You kind of see it as locking the door before you leave. But for some reason we don't do that yet in the online world. Now apart from the security, when I flew back from my trip to Iceland, I was watching the film Hidden Figures on the plane, which is an amazing film by the way, you should definitely see it. But it wasn't done yet and the plane was already landing. So when I came back home, I wanted to watch the rest of the film on Netflix. Unfortunately, it wasn't available in my country. So I did some research and found out that you could only watch this film from Canada. So I thought, let me just try and connect with NordVPN to Canada. And guess what? 10 seconds later, I was watching the rest of Hidden Figures on Netflix. Now it appears that this is even completely legal, so I'm definitely gonna do this more often. So honestly, my experience with NordVPN has been amazing. If you'd like to try it out yourself too, you can visit the first link in the description below or use the code CINECAM at checkout to get 75% discount for the next 3 years. And if you wouldn't like it after all, you can always get your money back in the first month. So go check it out. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button to see us every week. Stay creative.
What is that? I'm going to stomp. Whoa! Oh! Whee! Oh, shit. Oh.